Hello there guys, Blizzards here, and welcome to my quest guide on the quest Big Chompy Bird Hunting. For this quest, you're going to need level 5 Fletching, 30 Cooking, 30 Range, and there are no sub-quest requirements. For this quest, you're going to want about 150 Feathers, 6 Wolf Bones, which you can easily buy off the GE. You can obtain the Wolf Bones during the quest by killing wolves, but this is a lot easier. Some medium, you know, level healing food, tuna or lobster or monkfish will do fine, just because we're going to be running past some wolves and we don't want to die. And also some energy potions to speed up the quest, and some emergency teleports as well. In this quest, you're going to have to bring the ogre at some point during the quest, 3 of 6 set items. You can obtain these 3 items once you've found out which ones they are after the ogre has told you, but to make it easier, I'm actually going to bring all 6 of those items to the ogre already to make the quest faster. Actually 5 of the 6 items, sorry, can be bought off the ground exchange, while 1 must be obtained, which I'll show you how to get it. The 5 items you can get off the GE are a cabbage, a tomato, a potato, an onion, and equa leaves. And for your equipment, you're going to want just basically some light gear, like dragonhide, leather, things like that, not iron or bronze or whatever. Just light gear, which provides decent defense bonuses. This is because you're going to be running around, you don't want to have really heavy armor on the whole quest, and it's not really necessary. You can do the quest with no, you know, armor. You just might bring 1 or 2 extra food. You also want a magic short bow or, you know, something like that without ammo if you don't want to attack the wolves or anything like that, just in case you accidentally click on them. But you definitely do want a ring of dueling, which we're going to use to get there. Also for this quest, we're going to need a chisel, a knife, and a hatchet. But all of these things can be used in your tool belt. You can use the items in your tool belt. So make sure you either have in your inventory or in your tool belt, a chisel, a hatchet, and a knife. And once you've done that, I'm going to show you how to get the 6th item, which is a Dougal Leaf. So you start out at the front of the Grand Exchange. Sorry if I'm talking a little bit fast, but it's just because, why is it because? Because I've done this quest like 300 times now. It's not working out for me. Okay. So we'll pick the Dougal Leaves, and then we'll use our Ring of Dueling to teleport to Castle Wars. Okay, once we get to Castle Wars, I'm just going to walk out the front because it's a bit laggy in there. Okay, once we've got to Castle Wars, I will show you on the map exactly where we're going to need to go. Okay, so from here, we're going to need to go south, then east, all the way here, south again, and to here, where it says quest start. It's got this little emblem. That's where we start the quest. Okay. Exit that, and just follow exactly where I go. Okay, and once you get here, you're going to talk to Runs for quest start. Because I've already done the exact first screen window, he's going to say something different, but you'll get the same option. How do I make the stabbers? Just ask them about the stabbers and tell them you want to make him some. And all you do is walk over here and chop down this tree over here. And I'll just get 2. Okay, so you're going to right click craft wolf bones and turn them into wolf bone arrow tips. This is because I have the chisel in my tool belt. If you don't have it in your tool belt, you're going to have to use the chisel on the wolf bones. Once you've got all your arrow tips, you're going to have to craft the tree logs with your knife into arrow shafts. Again, this is because my knife is in my tool belt. If it's in your inventory, use the knife on the log. Also, I don't think 7's enough, so I'm just going to grab a couple more. And craft that. And once I've done that, I'll use the wolfbone arrow tips on the orc arrow shafts. There you go. Oh, sorry. You want to use the feathers on the arrow shafts first. That's better. And then use the arrow tips on the flighted orc arrows. Okay, once you've done that, talk to him. And give him the stabbers. Okay, now here you have to make sure you ask him all the options. Fatsy toads. Talking to this guy actually angers me. He's such a degenerate. Okay, once you're done. Okay, thanks. And you're going to have to go north into the cave over here. Now talk to either of them. Power right click. And I think they tell you that it's trapped in the orc chest. And I lifted it all off. So now I'll search the chest. And you find the orc bellows. Okay. So once you've got the orc bellows, you're going to want to leave the cave. Go southwest. And you're going to want to use the orc bellows on the swamp bubbles. Any of the swamp bubbles will do. And it will fill up all the way. And you're going to want to use the orc bellows on the swamp toads. I'm going to get 3. Just to be safe. Nope. There we go, and I might as well fill up my bellows. Okay, once you've done that, you're going to want to return to Rads. I think that's it. And he shows you, well, you show him the fatsy toad. And he tells you that's the right one. So, walk south to this little place where the yellow arrow is and drop the bloated toad there. Once you've done that, you want to run off. Talk to Rads, tell him you put the bait down. Okay. So, after a while, the chompy bird will appear. Stay far away so you can see it, but if you're further away, then there's more chance of the bird coming. And the second that you see the bird, you're going to want to talk to Rads, and he'll shoot at it. So you're just going to have to wait for a little bit until the bird comes. Okay, if what happens to you, what happened to me happened to you as well, and the bird doesn't appear, all you're going to have to do is just drop another bloated toad, and you might have to talk to him again. You place the bait. Okay, there we are, it's come. So talk to rats. No, there. Oh, finally he's seen it. Okay, and of course he blames your arrows. And ask him to let you have a go. Okay, so tell him to let you have a go. And tell him you're strong. Okay, so wield the orc bow and the orc arrows. Oh, and my bird's still here. Look at that. If the bird flew off, you're just going to have to put another toad down and wait for the bird to come. So once you've killed the bird, pluck the chompy bird and take the raw chompy. And talk to Rads. Okay. And he'll ask you for three things that he wants on his thing. He won't tell you all three things. He'll tell you one of the things he wants. And then you talk to his kids and they'll tell you what seasonings they like as well. So I think he said he likes tomato. He likes cabbage. Doesn't really matter. We don't have to worry about it because, as I said, we brought all three. Makes it a lot easier. Now, if you simply use the raw chompy on the fire, it will automatically pick the right seasonings and use them on it. So you don't have to click them and use it on the bird. And once you've got the seasoned chompy, talk to Rads. And there you go, quest complete. So as you can see, not a very hard quest at all. Quite a fast one. Much faster if you bring the required items before the quest start. And thank you very much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed my guide. If you need any other guides, I do have a few more on my channel. And I will be releasing them and PK commentaries and things like that. If you did enjoy it, give us a like, comment and subscribe. And I'll talk to you guys later. See ya.